together for our opening hymn, Christ Be Our Light.
Necessarily make it great, does it? All right, think about it. Do you know a great person? Do you even know somebody great? You? Yes, you are great. How about you, Miles? Your family? They are great. Anybody else? What do you think about you that's great?
Everything.
Awesome. How about you, Miles? What about your family that's so great? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. You have to speak up. They love you?
Yes.
Everybody loves you, Miles. That makes you great. All right, let me tell you a Bible story this morning. One day the disciples were walking among themselves, and they were arguing about who could be the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. They were very proud of themselves, and they felt for sure they would be one of them. So they asked Jesus, which one of us will be the greatest? What do you think? Do you think Jesus picked one? No, he didn't. He instead called a little child over here. Come here. Come here and stand beside me. Can someone stand, be a volunteer? Come here and stand beside me. And he said, I'm going to tell you the truth. Unless, come here, let me tell you. He put his arm around his little one and he said, I'll tell you the truth. Unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Whoever welcomes a child welcomes me. You know, sometimes we get all mixed up. We have greatness. We think that greatness means being powerful, rich, or having an important position in order to be great. But Jesus tells us that greatness is to be humble and to have a good heart, like these kids. That tells you what Jesus thinks about you. He thinks you're pretty great, doesn't he? We think you're pretty great, too. You have a lot. We, as adults, can learn a lot from you guys. Your good hearts and be humble. Let us take a prayer, please. Our most gracious Heavenly Father. Thank you for loving us. Help keep our hearts soft. And be humble. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
First, continue prayers for Ed and Helen Granger. They continue to have all kinds of health problems. Have been in and out of the hospital, both of them, over the last couple of weeks. So please continue to keep Ed and Helen in your prayers. A joy from last Sunday. Our goal for the crop walk was to raise $1,200. We ended up raising $1,449. So thank you to everybody who participated in the crop walk and to everybody who gave to help as we work to end hunger. Also, enjoy the Harvest Festival last night. We had a great time. I think we probably had 30 to 40 kids out here and 14 chili entries. Our winner, as he's already waved, was Brent Richardson. Congratulations to Brent. And we raised $445 for our youth program. So thank you to everybody who came out last night as well. Are there other joys or concerns left off this morning? Yeah, Jerry?
If
Continued prayers for Bonnie McCormick and Doris Carter. And on the good news side, I got a call from my brother yesterday, and Rose has gone down. She was in stage four. They've knocked it down below two, and she doesn't have any more chemo treatments to do. They're going to be a few times she's going to have some radiation shots, but other than that, she's doing a lot better.
Wonderful news there, okay. Bonnie McCormick and Doris Carter need prayers. Rose Britton has gone from stage four cancer down to stage two, and she's done with her chemo treatment, so that's wonderful news. Others, yeah, Bonnie?
Bill Sink and Hunter Cunningham.
Prayers for Bill Sink and Hunter Cunningham. Yeah, Becky?
Continued prayers for Tom Elvin. He is out of rehab at home and desperate care.
Continued prayers for Tom Elkins, Terry's brother. He's up there with Tom. He's his own freak out. He's still needing prayers. Yeah, Gary?
Two things. Prayer for Brad, what's your last name?
Brad Phillips.
And they were here this morning for rehearsal, and they had to leave until Brad was good to handle it. So they left. But Mary asked me to put a prayer in for her daughter-in-law's grandmother, whose name is Gail. She's in stage four cancer, and she asked for prayers for the family.
So, prayers for Brett Phillips, still having some pain from his knee replacement surgery a couple weeks ago. They were here briefly this morning, but had to leave due to his knee pain. And for Mary's daughter-in-law's grandmother, Gail, who has stage four cancer. Yeah, Harry. Continued prayers for Buck Shepard. Yeah, Sandy.
Prayers for Carlos and Judy Fletcher. They're in the process of looking for full-time care from him.
Prayers for Carlos and Judy Fletcher as they look for full-time care for Carlos. Yeah, Eva?
J.L. Gordon with back problems.
Mm-hmm. Prayers for J.L. Gordon, who's continuing to have back problems. Yeah, Sandy?
Hunter and the King family,
is they're still having a hard time. Yeah,
Ellen.
What's that?
Barbara Hawks.
Prayers for Barbara Hawks. Yeah, Ellen.
What's the name of the Connor family? The children. And everybody that is helping and everyone that's still recovering with all the international disasters that we've had within the past 6 months.
Prayers for the Connor family, particularly for the children, and prayers for those who are recovering, helping with recovery from the hurricanes and other natural disasters we've had recently. Other joys and concerns left off. Yeah, Mary?
I have joy. Our bridge was washed out during the rains, Michael rains, and we had two blessings happen during that whole thing. Your mother let us borrow her car, because both of our cars were on the wrong side of the creek. And Ronnie Moran and got his crew together to help us get some new pipes in, and now we are able to come.
That's wonderful. Thank you to Ronnie Moran for the work he did over at Perry and Gary's neighborhood, and to my mom, Holly Moore, who let them borrow her car. Yeah, Gary.
Joy, today is Barry and my anniversary.
Happy anniversary to Barry and Gary. Other joys or concerns? Yeah, Wayne?
Well, if we had seen, apparently got up in the, everything was spinning, so I called 911, and the ambulance got there, and she got about a mile away from the house, and the ambulance.
Oh my goodness.
She got up to the hospital and they did tests and everything on her. Found out she had a burn pit and they gave her medication and everything was good.
Prayers for Carolyn, who found out she has vertigo, and for the ambulance drivers. It's got to be a difficult situation when the ambulance breaks down. It's also a good time to pray for all of our first responders, the ways that they help so many of us. Yes, Sandy?
Hey,
prayers for Larry Blankenship, who's having his first chemo treatment this week. Other joys and concerns. Yeah, Carol?
I just want to say I have a joy because I have such a great church family, and I really appreciate everyone here.
Well, we appreciate you too, Carol. Let's go together to God in prayer. Lord, we pray that by your Spirit, our eyes and our hearts would be open to the world around us, that we might see in each living being your creation and your love, so that we might respond to those in need with the eyes and love of a child. Lord, we lift up each of those we have named here today, knowing that they also are your beloved creation. Ed and Helen Granger, those who participated in the crop walk and those who were served by the crop walk, for the joy of the Harvest Festival. Bonnie McCormick, Doris Carter, Rose Britton, Bill Sink, Hunter Cunningham, Tom Elkins, Brett Phillips, Gail, Buck Shepherd, Carlos and Judy Fletcher, J.L. Gordon, Hunter and the King family, Barbara Hawks, the Connor family, all of those who are suffering from hurricanes and natural disasters, and those who are helping to rebuild. Holly Wolf, Ronnie Moran, Mary Lure and Gary Baldwin, Carolyn, the first responders, Larry Blankenship, and our church family. Lord, we give you thanks that we know we are your beloved creation. Help us to live your love in the world. We pray this in Jesus' name, as we pray together the words that he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. On the night that he was betrayed, Jesus instituted the Lord's Supper. He took a loaf of bread, and he blessed it, and he broke it. And he took the cup, and he blessed it, and he poured it. But he did something else as he and the disciples gathered around the table. He washed each of their feet as a reminder of the need for humility and service among the greatest in the kingdom of God. It is around this table that we remember not only his offering of his body and of his blood, but of his love and of his service to his disciples and to us. Connecting the foot washing with the meal is a reminder to us that Jesus' death and resurrection is an act of service, and it is the kind of act that we are called to follow in to show Christ's love for the world. Let's prepare for our time of communion as we stand together and sing our communion hymn, the service song. Let's stand and sing.
Christ to you, pray that I may.
seated. For it was on the night that Christ was betrayed, that during supper he took a loaf of bread, he blessed it and he broke it, saying, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Take and eat of it in remembrance of me."
May we pray? Father, we pause at your table as we do each week, thanking you for your gift, the gift of your Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, whose body was broken that we might have life eternal with you. We ask now, Father, that you would bless this bread as we take it, let your Spirit enter us, and give us strength for the coming week. For these things we pray in Christ's holy name.
The world is watching to see if we live out what we proclaim, that love and service will bring about the kingdom, that looking after the least of these, that being like a child, will help bring about God's kingdom. What we do with our time, with our talents, and with our money answers that question. It tells the world whether or not we really believe in this Christ who we proclaim. Let's receive our tithes and offerings. tithes and offerings, a symbol of your lordship in our lives. We ask that you bless them and bless us that we might do the work of bringing your kingdom into this world. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Verses 35 through 45. Here Jesus was teaching about serving others. Then James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came to him. "Teacher," they said, "we want you to do for us whatever we ask." "What do you want me to do for you?" he asked. They replied, "Let one of us sit at your right and the other at your left in your glory." "You don't know what you're asking," Jesus said. "Can you drink the cup I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?" "We can," they answered. He said to them, "You will drink the cup I drink and be baptized with the baptism I am baptized with. But to sit at my right or left is not for me to grant. These places belong to those for whom they've been reserved." When the ten heard this, they became indignant with James and John. Jesus called them together and said, "You know that those who are regarded as rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their high officials exercise authority over them. Not so with you. Instead, whoever wants to become great among you, you must be your servant. And whoever wants to be first must be slave of all. For even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." This is a word of our Lord.
Contest.
Well, it was Miss Tilly's idea to have that pie eating contest, so
So, of course, she was obligated to attend.
Yes, they fired a gun to start the pie, and everything was down in a split second, just to gobble those pies. It was such a mess. Oh, but then all of a sudden, Miss Tilly's allergies started acting up. But she was in it to win it.
And then it happened.
What?
Well, Miss Tilly sucked a blue rag right up her nose. And it went down the wrong way. And bam! She was gone.
May she rest in peace.
That blueberry.
Yes, yes. The blueberry.
Come in.
Hi, Dean. How are you?
Hi, how are you?
Hi, y'all. Blueberry. It's election year. I got some good news for you.
Oh, what's that?
Yeah, today in my office I got a letter from the president of Better America.
Oh, we all heard that magazine.
Better America. I get that magazine over at the barber shop.
Somehow they got wind of your fall festival, right? And somehow their East Coast people are going to send one of the representatives to here and spend the night right here. For Bing. Happy to see you, Bing.
Oh my goodness.
That's great. I can't believe it. Yeah.
Someone on the list and call them up and make up an excuse.
Oh, Andy, I couldn't do that. Could I?
Miss Taylor, just think of the great publicity you have.
Really?
Oh, really?
I know that magazine goes everywhere. It's everywhere. Yep.
Why, it could put you on the map.
Well, think about it, Bean. This could just change your life.
A blueberry?
Yes, a blueberry.
Well, the extra business would be nice.
Oh, it would help out the whole family.
Oh, really? Miss Taylor, just think about it, okay? Get back to me as soon as possible. I've got a 2 o'clock meeting. I've got some errands I've got to do, but call me, you hear?
Yes, Mayor, of course.
Sure. Y'all take care. It's election year.
We'll see y'all there.
Don't get that appointment tomorrow now.
Oh, yeah. Do that. Hi, girl. Don't forget to tell your dad to vote for me.
Why, Jan, Marcia, why are the long faces?
Well, you see, Andy, we have to move one girl to the varsity cheer team.
Well, you two should be able to figure that out.
But we have to choose between our best friend and the new girl who's really good.
Oh, that could be a problem.
But the new girl's dad runs the cheer team and helped us win championships.
I could see there could be a dilemma.
But our best friend has always been there and shows up to every practice. The new girl was here last if she was late.
Well, I can see why you're both concerned. But you girls are both so smart, and you're strong, and you're faith. But God, you know, I bet if you pray about it, and you talk to God, I bet He'll help you decide, and you'll do the right thing. Does that help?
Yeah. Thanks, Nancy.
All right, girl, come on. Y'all can go work too. Bye-bye, girl.
Bye-bye, girl.
Yeah, call them. That man snores like a pig in a horse race. Well, you can hear him all over town, Aunt B.
But he always comes over and gets a shave and a haircut and we change. He doesn't know about
not swings. They both stink to high heaven.
Andy, that's not nice.
Well, I've never smelled so much garlic in all my life. They must eat it morning, noon, and night.
Well, now, Andy, you know garlic is good for you. Haven't you heard that?
They've been coming here for 7 years. I don't think it'd be right to do that to them.
Well, you don't want to call the honeycuts.
Oh, no. They just love my pickles.
Now there's a reason. Well, how about the needle myers? I've never understood one word that man says anyway.
He talks like he's got a mouthful of peanut butter.
Well, you know, she has relatives that live in this area. I don't think I can do that for them.
Well, B, there's only one thing left to do.
What? What?
It was a blueberry?
Yes, it was a blueberry.
What?
Well, you take the advice you just gave the girls a while ago and apply to your own situation.
You know, you're right. I know what I'm going to do. Sarah? Hey, Sarah, this is me. Get me in Mayor's office, please. Why, no, I'm not going to take the offer. How did you know? Well, never mind. Get me to Mayor's office. Thank you. Mayor, hey, this is me. Yep, I thought it over. And I thank you very much for the offer, but there's just no room in the inn. Thank you.
Oh, B, that was the right decision.
Yes.
I'm proud of you, Aunt B.
You done good.
Yes, it was.
It was the right thing to do. Well, come on, let's get this together. We've got a fall festival going on.
Oh, yes.
Get those letters. Get
them tied.
So what do you do? You've got the opportunity of your life. You've worked towards this moment, towards an opportunity to get yourself put on the map. And all you have to do is one little thing. Maybe a little bit dishonest, or maybe a little bit wrong, or maybe just not the way you have run your business up until now. Just one time. You're not going to do it all the time, just this once. And you've got a chance to be great, to have the success you've always dreamed of. What do you do? We're told that success, that greatness is within our grasp, that all of our dreams can come true. If we just work hard enough, if we just do everything exactly right. But here's the thing. We're pretty terrible at defining what success means. Did Aunt B start a B&B so she could be famous? Did Aunt B start a bed and breakfast so that she could be on the map? So that everybody would know who she was and where she was? Is the town of Mayberry or Salem or whatever town there to make sure that they draw as many people in as possible to make money, to be well known? Is that the purpose? Is that what we were made for? In this morning's scripture, James and John, they can see it. Sitting at Jesus' left hand and right hand, the most important, the greatest of disciples, they can go through whatever challenges they need to go through. Israel Ninja Warrior, they're ready. Whatever it takes. all that matters is that they're the top two. And guess what's going to happen once they're the top two? Then they're going to want to know which one of them is number one. Then they're going to have to battle it out to have the title between the brothers. We know how it works. When we get focused on greatness, when we get focused on success, we get focused on something that is abstract rather than what God has made us for. But when we follow Christ, the road leads down. It does not lead us to what we would consider greatness, what we would consider success. It doesn't put us on the map. Most of the known world at the time of Christ's crucifixion had no idea what was happening on a hill just outside of Jerusalem. Most of the known world had no idea that 2,000 years later, billions would gather to worship him, to remember him, to celebrate him. In Christ's kingdom, those who want to be great must be servants of all, must not seek after their own adulation, after their own fame, after their own sense of righteousness or success, but rather they must look around them every moment and be a servant to all. She made the right decision. But she made the right decision not just from an abstract place, but from who she was. She's a bed and breakfast owner. She is one who provides a place to stay for any and all who would come to her. She's not worried about success and greatness. All she needed to be was a reminder of who God made her to be. But success and greatness, looking upwards rather than down, it leads us away from who we were made to be. It leads us away from who we are in our depths. If we want to learn more about ourselves, we must look downwards, we must serve. We must find opportunities to look after those around us. Loneliness and partisanship are an all-time high in our country, probably in our world, because we keep looking up for the answers rather than looking around us, rather than saying each and every one of us holds innate value, rather than saying that each and every part of God's creation is beloved. We look up. But once we look up, we have to decide who can't fit in anymore. We have to push somebody out. There's no room in the inn. Who do we push out? The question before us today and every day is, who am I? And what does it mean for my life here and now? Rather than looking off into the distance, rather than looking up to those who the world says is important or are great, we need to be with Christ right here, right now, saying, what can I do? What am I called to do? Who and how can I serve here? God sent Jesus to Bethlehem, to Nazareth, to all sorts of towns out in the countryside, across the Sea of Galilee, to serve the least of these, those that society had forgotten about. And if we are going to follow him, we must walk upon the downward road. We must say, who is it? Who is it, Lord, that you have made me to be, and how is it you have made me to serve those around us? We have the answer before us to what ails the world. It is the love of Christ and the service to others. It seems too simple. It seems too easy. But the work of Christ is hard when we follow it. And so, today and every day, we must ask ourselves the question, will I follow Christ on that road where I will learn more about who I am, who I was made to be? Or will I focus on the things that the world tells me are important, are great, that really matter? We cannot follow Jesus while seeking greatness. That much is made clear in this morning's scripture. And so, do we follow Jesus on the downward road? Or do we follow this world that continues to be divided by hatred and anger? The choice is ours. Amen.
Amen.
If there is anyone here today who has not previously made a profession of faith in the one who showed the way to true greatness, we invite you to come forward and do so. If there is anyone who would like to follow, join us as we follow after Christ. To serve those around us, we invite you to come forward and do so. And if there is anyone here who would like to rededicate their life to following Jesus Christ, we invite you to come forward and do so. As we stand together and sing our hymn of invitation, let's stand and sing.
Mercy, mercy, and only bread.
benediction and a moment of silence. Go into the world, knowing that Christ is waiting for you to lead you where you need to go. Go and serve with the love of Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Thomas Center at Richfield. We go and serve those in the memory care unit by offering them communion and song. If you can come and join us, it is an absolutely wonderful opportunity to go and serve those that many in society have forgotten. So if you can make it tomorrow at 2 o'clock, come on out and join us as we lead a 30-minute worship service and communion service at Joseph C. Thomas. We're going to celebrate one of our own this Saturday. Miss Betty Richardson is turning, it says it on the sheet, Betty, so I'm not saying that, I'm just reading the sheet. She's turning 90 years young this week. Happy birthday, Betty. You can drop by the church from 2 to 5 this Saturday, October 27th. Next Sunday is our youth and children-led worship service. This service is being built around the ways that kids and youth experience God. And so they've written large parts of the worship service, and we have gotten their input in terms of how we're going to go about it. So come on out. It is going to be an absolute blessing. And when we talk about learning and serving, this is a great way for us to learn from our kids how they are learning about God and what they know about God. So please plan to be here for that. Following worship, we will have our congregational meeting. That's for 2019-2020 officers, elders, and deacons, and for our 2019-2020 budget. So plan on hanging around for probably 30 minutes or so after worship next Sunday. And then finally, November 16th and 17th, it doesn't seem like it should be close, but it is closer than we think. We will have our fall yard sale. We want anything and everything. If you can help out, see Miss Betty Richardson. Betty, give another little wave. We're also going to need strong backs that week. Anybody who's got a strong back who can find a little bit of time to help get some of the heavier stuff in, please let me know. I'm going to organize that. Yeah, Gary.
Just to tag on the children's service, we're having our Saturday workshop this Saturday.
This Saturday morning at 10 o'clock, we will have our final workshop / practice for any kids who want to be involved. And then at 9:30 next Sunday, we need all of the kids involved to be here by 9:30 so we can do one final run-through of the service. And if your kids want to be involved, please let me know. Anybody who's got a few minutes to hang around after church today and is willing to let their child be interviewed on camera, I'll have a camera and I'm going to ask just a few questions, put together a video for the service as well.
Please be involved in that. It's going to make it very worthwhile.
Any way that we can have our kids involved is such a blessing. Let's get out there and give them heaven.